Dozens of erring personnel at the Philippine Internal Revenue Bureau are ordered suspended. The government's chief taxman, Romeo Lumagi Jr., says the officials were suspended for grave misconduct and gross neglect of duty, among others. Lumagi adds the suspensions are part of their campaign to ensure integrity at the agency. For a think tank, reforms should not be about opening up the economy and attracting more foreign investments. Ibon Foundation Executive Director Sunny Africa says policy changes should focus on how the public and private sectors can use foreign capital to contribute to long-term national development.
The policy question isn't how to attract foreign investment, as if on its own it's a magic bullet for development. Why is foreign investment not developing the Philippine economy? Because we don't have that policy framework to regulate foreign direct investment for development, the gains are very exaggerated and they are really not showing up, I think, in the macroeconomic figures right now.
Cybersecurity solutions firm said cyber attacks could be more frequent this year. Lady Vicencio is back on the line for more. Lady?
Yes, Denise, a survey conducted by the IDC showed almost 56% of organizations reported at least twice an increase in the number of ransomware attacks. Fortinet Asia Vice President of Marketing and Communications Rashish Pandey said ransomware is now even offered as a service by syndicates. He emphasized that as technology gets sophisticated, bad actors are also finding more ways to get information through social engineering, phishing attacks, and hacking IT infrastructure. Aside from ransomware, other common cyber threats in the Philippines are phishing, identity theft, patching vulnerabilities, and insider threats. As remote work became a trend since the COVID-19 pandemic, experts also see it as a threat in cybersecurity. Rashish connected insider threats to remote work as more employees use unsecured public Wi-Fi in cafes, hotels, and other public areas. Respondents of the survey said insufficient employee training on cybersecurity has led to an increase in insider threats. The survey also showed 50% of businesses do not have dedicated resources for cybersecurity teams. IDC survey also noted that the average time to detect and remediate an attack takes 21 days. But with the security operations in place, the timeline could be shortened to 18.5 hours. Fortinet reported in 2023 that an average breach cost in the Philippines is 55 million pesos, but investing on security operations may be able to mitigate and lessen the time of exposure and cost. The company also advised organizations to take advantage of automated and artificial intelligence-powered security operations to detect and respond to threats faster. Denise?
Thanks, Lady, for that report. No cash aid coming the way of farmers who recently incurred losses, either due to pests or oversupply issues. Now, for more on that story, let's bring in our correspondent, Katrina Domingo. Kat, go ahead.
Hi, Denise. The government has no fund to provide cash aid for farmers who incurred losses due to pests and oversupply issues. That's according to Department of Agriculture Secretary Francisco Chu Laurel. He said that a day after several farmers in Cordillera in Cebu were forced to throw away cabbages due to oversupply, while onions in Nueva Ecija were hit by pests. Chu Laurel says technically there is no fund to help them, but he adds that the DA is willing to give them seeds to replant and pesticides, along with it, some other kinds of support. He mentions that the pest problem that hit the onion industry in Nueva Ecija will have some effect on onion prices, but underscores that the spike is not expected to be significant. He says so far the DA is still looking at more viable solutions to aid farmers in Nueva Ecija. Now, as for the oversupply problem, the DA says it is actually focusing on building more cold storage plant facilities across the country as the Philippines loses about 30% of its vegetable production due to wastage. That's, again, according to DA Secretary Francisco Chu Laurel, who says that 30% of our produce of vegetables has gone to waste due to poor logistics in our supply chain. He said, if we hasten, or if the Philippines hastens or eliminates these losses, then that will be equivalent to about 10 to 15% of cost reduction to our vegetables and fruits. As for rice and corn, he says around 450,000 tons are wasted in the Philippines annually, which equates to about 12 to 15% of total production. The DA secretary adds that the Philippines can save some 10.5 billion pesos annually if there will be no rice and corn wastage. The country can also reduce its rice imports by 10%, he says, noting that the country stores some 3.5 million tons of rice from international producers in 2023. Now, Denise, the DA is pushing to get about 93 billion pesos in the next 3 years to put up cold storage facilities in Luzon, Visayas, and Mindanao. He says the facilities are expected to be located in FDI Taguig, Mindoro, Sariaya in Quezon Province, as well as either in La Union or Benguet, where provinces from the Cordillera region actually merge. The facilities for Visayas and Mindanao have yet to be determined. Denise?
Thanks, Kat, for that report.